Pottery Pals, I've got a little quick process that I'd like to show you. I've got all my trimmings out of the trimming bucket. You've seen my trimming bucket. It's let me flip you guys around here. You see my trimming wheel that's over here, and I usually just let the trimmings accumulate, and they go down into one of these totes down there. Well, I pull that out after a while, and then I take those trimmings and I put them in a bucket, and then I take some of my nasty slip, which usually comes out of that bucket. I accumulate that out over time. I'll pour that into here, and I'll leave it about this thick. You can notice how thick that is. That's like, you know, a really thick oatmeal. And that's all I want to do. But then, what I do, I'm not sure if you can see me, but I'll just have my phone. Darvan 7. Darvan 7 is a, it's a deflocculant. It's a wetting agent. I'll put up a little information about Darvan 7 because I actually really don't know what it is. But it makes really good casting slip, and that's what we're making for my skulls and whatnot. So. Get that open. And we're just going to pour a little of this in here. Not a whole lot, maybe about that much. Then, put this back over here, I'm going to start stirring it, and watch what happens. It starts loosening up a lot. Why do we use this in order to, you know, molecularly change it in that way rather than just add water? Well, the thing about casting slips is you want them to be wet without being wet. You want them to be, you know, very flowing and actually not have that much water in them. The act of flocculation as opposed to deflocculation. So we are definitely deflocculating this to the point to where it's water. Alrighty, well, that's about exactly where I want that casting slip right now. The viscosity is perfect on it. I am going to take that and I'm going to run it through one of these. This has probably been 80 mesh screen. The numbers have long since fallen off of it. I think that's probably more like a 60 mesh, doesn't really matter. I'm gonna run that through this into that bucket, and that'll get out all the little particles of grog. Grog, as we know, is the little fired pieces of crushed brick and clay that they put into clay bodies to give them more thermal shock value, to use for like Raku. I use a lot of Raku, so there's a lot of grog in there. But this will also get, like, you know, zippy ties or any, you know, buttons or whatever the heck is in that, because that's my trimming funk from the trimming wheel. So yeah, this will purify it completely, and then we'll be able to start pouring it into molds and making more skulls and whatnot. So that's how I make my casting slip. It's really not that difficult. I know that everything that came out of there is cone 6 fired clay, so I know my firing latitude for it. There's a bunch of different types of clays in there, but they're all cone 6. So I know that if I fire up the mold to, not the mold, the thing that comes out of the mold, the casting, to cone 6, it's going to be okay. And I haven't had a problem yet, so yeah, it works for me. So if I had added too much Darvan 7 and it got really liquidy, well, for one, it'd be really easy to run through the screen, but I'd probably have to thicken it up a little bit. And how you do that is you add a little bit of Epsom salts in liquid, and that pulls it back the other direction. You don't really want to do that with your casting slip too much, because you can get it too flocculated, over-flocculated, and it'll get sticky again. And if it's sticky, it'll never, ever, ever, ever dry in the mold. You'll be leaving the mold out for like a week going, this thing still fell apart when I tried to pull it apart. So yeah, this is how to get your molds to work. I'll show you what it looks like after it's come out of the mold and how it wants to peel off of your plaster. It's just like magic. It's really cool. Well, there's no zippy ties or buttons or fingernails or anything in there. There's an awful lot of grog. And here's what I was talking to you about. You can see that grainy grittiness in there. It's a little dark in here, sorry. But yeah, and you know, once you get to a certain point, no more of that's going to go through there. So we're going to have to just toss that out. I mean, if I wanted to save the grog for some reason, but I have grog, so I don't need to save it. Okay, so I have poured all three of these molds. These are my skulls that I sell a lot of for the tankards, the skull growlers that I make. And I went ahead and just did it without showing you guys, because, I mean, it's kind of boring. I basically just take one of these and fill each one in turn. About 20 minutes after these have set for a while, that allows enough, you know, accumulation around the inside of the mold to be fairly decent with these particular skull molds. And after my timer goes off at 20 minutes, which is probably about 50 minutes from now, I'll pour each one of these back into that bucket in turn, and then set them all out here and turn the fan on them for about a day. About this time tomorrow, I will pull these out of the molds. They should be fine. This material, I'll show it to you when it's done. If this dries properly, it'll start curling up like a piece of chocolate or something, because it'll get so dry and pull away from that mold. That's the sign of a perfect casting slip. Also, the little minor holes that I have in the molds, they filled up, they stopped flowing really, really quickly. Which is another sign that that it's a good casting slip. I missed quite a bit right there. But that's okay. That'll turn into like a big piece of chocolate and pull right off of there. Hopefully, if our casting slip is working properly. And then I'll show you the molds, the skulls, when they come out. I have them drying in front of the fan now after I poured them out. It's been about 20 minutes that they sat in the slip sat in the molds. I poured them out, and now the fan is blowing on them, and I should touch base with you guys here in about 12 to 24 hours, and we'll pull one of them out and see how it did. More later. Okay, now it's been at least 24 hours later, and if you can look and see what the surface of this, see how that just peels right off of the plaster. That's a sign of a good casting slip. So, we're gonna try and take one of these out. It might be a little difficult, so I won't sit here and pound on the mold. I will show you the mold when it starts coming loose. We'll start with probably one of these. I pulled this up, and you can see how relatively clean it is. This is overflow, because these really don't hold the clay as well as it used to. But there's the front. Sorry about the darkness. The back came out too, which is perfect. So I'll go ahead and get it the rest of the way. I can't really do it with one hand, so I'll just put it on pause and see what happens. Let's see if we can get it off here without damaging it overtly. With one hand. There's the bottom part of it. Most of these molds are made the exact same way. Again. And there's pretty much one of the skulls. Could almost get it out by the one hand. I did. And there's one of my skulls in the mold. As you can see, there's going to be a lot of cleanup. But not bad. Our new casting slip seems to have worked just fine.